every time you strapped on that World Wrestling Federation championship belt, Macho Man. But he's posed the question. He wants to know, will you put the title on the line against Hulk Hogan, Macho?
My answer, Hulk Hogan, is that I am going to think about it,
Sounds good to me, Hogan. You think about it because Macho gave you no answer.
The crowd in Tucson to its feet, truly one of a kind. There's going to be a styling job done here this week.
Now, how do you know that, McMahon?
Because everywhere the barber goes, there's going to be a little cut instead, a little strut.
I'm waiting for the day that the barber gets beat, uh-huh, and we get to watch the opponent strut and cut.
Could happen.
By the way, how come you're not patting me on the back a little for that exclusive interview I just got done with?
Okay, it was exclusive, all right, but to my way.
It's a good thing I'm around here to get that type of information.
Information? All he said was he's going to think about it, Jesse. He didn't say, if the man had the kind of intestinal fortitude that you seem to think he has, he would have unquestionably stated, yes, I'll take Hulk Hogan on. I'll take him on anytime.
Sure, and that's exactly what people like you, people like Hogan, and everybody else want. Macho to make a decision based on emotion, yeah, instead of a decision based on practicality and brain power. Macho is no dummy. I think thinking about it for a week is exactly the right thing to do to determine if Hogan truly indeed is the number one contender.
Well, if in fact, I'll grant you that if in fact he's doing this in terms of psychological deployment, yes, it's likely to work because Hulk Hogan is going to have a very restless week thinking about whether or not the Macho Man will accept the challenge. I'll grant you that.
If I was Macho Man, I wouldn't do it.
Well, Jesse,
I'd make Hogan stew around for as long as time would let me.
Well, Brutus the Barber Beefcake thus far in control of this matchup against Sid Sharkey.
You think for 1 minute if Hogan was the champion, he just automatically defended against Macho? I don't think so.
Oh, I do. I think Hulk Hogan is a very emotional man. There's no question of that.
Hogan was notorious for ducking people. He ducked me for years.
Oh, please, Jesse. I mean, you have to be ranked in the top 10. You weren't even the top 50.
What are you talking about, not in the top 50, McMahon? What a short memory you got. I was the number one contender for probably better than a year and a half to 2 years with Hogan ducking me and never did get a title shot.
Well, if you ever did get one, you probably would wind up like Sid Sharkey going down. Sid Sharkey is almost a three pin. The barber has done it again. And yes, indeed, there's going to be a little stretch going. In his strut, Brutus the Barber Beefcake here in Tucson, Arizona.
This is disgusting.
What,
yeah, there he goes. There he goes. Over to get scissors, make a fool out of this guy who's just been in there trying to do the best he could in athletic competition, and this is what he gets out of it.
Hey, listen, when you sign on for a match with Brutus, then you know what the result possibly could be. And Sharkey, for free, is no extra charge. Getting a little bit off the sides now. Maybe a little bit off the top. All right, Brutai, once again victorious. We'll take you down to the World Boxing Federation Event Center.
Welcome back. Saturday evening, March 11th, it will happen at the Nashville Auditorium. The Red Rooster, no longer coached by Bobby the Brain Heenan. He has a new man, and he is the Brooklyn Brawler. Right now, those two are standing by.
Well, Rooster, you didn't want to trust me. You thought you could do it on your own. Well, you can trust me now, pal. You can trust me, because I'm going to make sure you get the beating of your life.
Look at his face. You know you can trust me.
That's my Brooklyn Brawler. He can walk down any street, any time of night and day, and the path opens up. And Rooster, I hope you're standing in the middle of that path, because this man right here is going to take you apart, limb
by limb.
Well, Bobby Heenan never short on words, and he had a lot to say about this matchup. The Brooklyn Brawler to face the Red Rooster. The Big Boss Man in the main event to meet the Ultimate Warrior.
You've been working tall and proud for a long time in the WWF, but the Warriors know that things have changed over the course of the last year, and the power of the Ultimate Warrior is totally out of control. But you, Boss Man, think you have what it takes. You think that 17-size boot is what it takes to put the Ultimate Warrior down. Oh, the rage that builds in me is something that you're gonna have to deal with, Boss Man, because I show no mercy to any man, whether he be an officer of the law or a creature of some unknown nature. You, Boss Man, are nothing but a piece of meat, and I eat raw meat every day.
The Intercontinental Champion, the Ultimate Warrior, he has a law all his own, and he plans to have the Big Boss Man answer to it. The two will meet Saturday night, March 11th.